Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's me, Irvin, with another manga chapter review. This is going to be on chapter 23 and 24 of The Elusive Samurai. Now, this is going to be found on Shonen Jump, and it's a series that I've been reviewing for quite a bit. So you guys can find quite a bit of videos already out in my channel. Not sponsored by Shonen Jump, so you guys can find it in their website or anywhere else you want to find it. But it is a good series, and I personally myself have really, really enjoyed it. And like I said in my previous video, I do realize it's probably not one of my biggest series where a lot of people enjoy watching it, but I do know quite a few people that are close to the channel do. So I myself have put my mission to at least I'm enjoying it and they are as well. So here we are reviewing chapter 23 and 24 of The Elusive Samurai. And before anything else, if you have not done so by now, make sure you subscribe to my channel. A lot of you guys are watching but not subscribing, so make sure you subscribe, comment, like, and share as well if you haven't done so by now. And that helps tremendously, really improve the channel itself. We are trying to reach 4,700, so hopefully we can do that sooner than later. Okay, chapter 23 is it's sort of a conclusion, and 24 is not too far from it either. So 23, essentially, we see what the aftermath of the battle, and our leader Tsukiyoki essentially has defeated the commander from the other side called Shokan. Now Shokan, we assume he's dead in chapter 22, but in 23 we find out that he is actually not dead. What ends up happening is that Shokan has reinforcements show up. I don't know if he himself commanded them or they showed up in just a hunch, but it is the Sakafusa and the Ogasawara guys, the two leaders who have the good hearing and the good eyesight, and they show up. And we've known from previous chapters that these guys are dangerous guys. They can pretty much kill these kids pretty quickly still. Now, granted, these kids have experience in invading these guys already, but still, these kids are hurt, they're tired. It's a whole different story from before. So they kind of seem like they're being surrounded, and at the same time, we see Yorishige, which is the shrine leader, shows up with the reinforcements as well. I believe Gemba is the one that went and picked him up, and obviously that ended up being in their favor and helps them out. I'm gonna turn on my vehicle because it's getting hot in here, to be honest. So anyways, it ends up being a benefit for them, and Gemba and Yorishige are there to basically protect rightful heir, who obviously no one knows but closest friends to him. It becomes official. Tsukiyoki asks Fubuki to be one of his underlings, and Fubuki first is against it, but when he finds out who Tsukiyoki actually is, agrees to be under him. The rest of the chapter, we basically see Shokan being rescued by his fellow warriors, and essentially they ask him to recover in some small land and to stop going and attacking villages. Now, the reason they say this is because when you're trying to build a empire, you want to tax people, and these other two guys, Ichikawa and Agasawara, they know that they need people to tax. They need people under them. So them going into villages and destroying them and killing everyone, it doesn't work well for them. So they tell Shokan, hey, chill out, right? We're here, we're gonna help you, you're not gonna die, but chill out. We don't need you killing off the people that we're gonna take advantage from. So it seems like they're gonna enter into a peace time for time being. Now, chapter 24, we get this whole story of Tsukiyoki helping Yorishige get his powers back. Back in chapters maybe 16-17, we learned that Yorishige was losing his future sight powers, which can be very important, especially to help them realize when they'll be in danger or not. And Tsukiyoki is helping him out, and after a comical half of chapter of him basically trying to hide it and everyone wondering what the heck he's doing with all the random items he's carrying. He finally gets the right item and he goes to this pond essentially to get water for Yorushika to actually recover his powers. And in there is Yorushika's daughter, and she is essentially giving thanks and doing a ritual for spirits. Now, Togeki kind of finds this weird, and he himself is still unsure if powers are any even something that should even be considered helpful, because are they real? How do they work? And Yorushika's daughter kisses Togeki to give him temporary powers to see the spirits. And Togeki's able to see spirits. He's able to see all these spirits in the pond, essentially, that are there resting. And we kind of, I guess, enter the more mythical part of the actual series. They have been taunting us with, you know, Yorushika having powers and, you know, him being able to see the future and all that. But it was stuff, and it's mentioned in the chapter, it's stuff that could have been also like just coincidence, or could have been stuff that, you know, you can guess. You can guess pretty well. Like I've watched so much stuff. I mean, anime, movies, you name it. I mean, this channel obviously is an anime channel, but I still watch Marvel. I still watch musicals. I still watch action movies. I still watch rom-coms with my wife. So I watch so much stuff on top of just anime itself, that whenever I watch something, I can tell sometimes what's going to happen next. In fact, I've been told by friends and by my wife to shut up sometimes, because, you know, I'm pretty good at assuming and guessing what's going to happen next in the show, because a lot of them follow the same structure. With it, I kind of feel like Yorushika could have maybe said something like that. Like, you know, they're not real powers, but I'm just really good at tactics and knowing what's going to happen next because of my experience. That could have been a good explanation, but it seems like the manga has chosen to go more into the mythical, you know, god goddesses type of genre, which is fine, but with so much history being thrown at us and it being as much as possible historically accurate as much as possible, which is, you know, not a lot, but it seemed odd that they wanted to take that direction more. And I'm a little bit unsure if it's gonna like change a little bit, or if that's gonna explain maybe the good sight, the good hearing of all these other enemies and so on and so forth. So I guess we'll see how this evolves, but for now I'm just on the fence. So yeah, chapter 25 and 26 will be out pretty soon. I am trying my best again to record as many of these videos as possible to get them out, and also frequently, not just once in a while like I've been doing for the past 3-4 months. My room is being built. I will have TikToks out so you guys can see as the room is being built, but eventually I'll be reacting in that room pretty soon. Just built my chair, and now I just gotta get some stuff set up for me to have enough place to react on video. So I'm excited for all that, and it's just coming around the corner, and it's so close. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this. If you have not done so by now, subscribe to my channel, give some love by liking, commenting, and sharing this video. Also, let me know what you like about so far this series. I know Lee Cheer and some of you guys others here in the channel really do enjoy this series, and I myself am enjoying it too. I'm a little fence on what direction they're going to take from now on, but we'll see. I think there's about 40 chapters out, so I'm still a little behind, but I'll catch up as fast as possible. Thank you again, and guys, like always, don't be strangers. See you guys.